you prayed and believed your whole life, and here you are. Explain that to me.
What do you say to people that are offended by your show because you pray to Jesus in every episode?
If we disown him, he'll disown us.
When a 12-year-old watches his mother dying of cancer, a God who would allow that is not worth believing in. Life is really a tale told by an idiot, full of sound and fury and signifying nothing.
I am Professor Radisson. This is Philosophy 150. I would like to bypass senseless debate altogether and jump to the conclusion, which every sophomore is already aware of: there is no God. All that I require from each of you is that you fill in the papers I've just given you with three little words: God is dead.
Mr. Wheaton, is something wrong?
I can't do what you want. I'm a Christian.
If you cannot bring yourself to admit that God is dead, then you will need to defend the antithesis.
So your acceptance of this challenge may be the only meaningful exposure to God and Jesus they'll ever have.
See, to me, he's not dead. I don't want anyone to get talked out of believing in him just because his professor thinks they should.
Mr. Wheaton, are you ready?
God's not dead, he's surely alive. He's living on the inside, roaring like a lion. God's not dead, surely alive. He's living on the inside, roaring like a lion.
Science supports his existence, you know the truth. So why do you hate him? It's a very simple question. Why do you hate God?
He's surely alive. He's living on the inside, roaring like a lion.
We all walk on a razor's edge, a thin line between life and death.
All of a sudden, I just got this crazy feeling, and I knew that it was my dad. And I just said, no. No, no.
The vast majority of my life has already been lived. I don't have very much longer. I know that.
If there's a life hanging in the balance, we're willing to put ours on the line so that they may live. And I came to the realization that this was it.
Breaking news now.
I'm overcome with anger.
You're not going to escape it.
No death, no pain, no sorrow.
And I want to ask you tonight, are you prepared? Are you ready?
No, he's going to put that in his mouth and become one of the 400 estimated people that die from acute salmonella.
Do not put that finger in your...
Oh, you having a rough morning?
Tell me it's all going to be okay.
It's all going to be okay. Just give it 5 years.
Year seven or five...
You have to choose to do something for yourself.
I planned this mom's night thing for Saturday.
You planned a mom's night?
Yes, sister.
What's the worst thing that can happen?
They could get maimed. I could lose both children. It's getting hot in here.
Wow, you look amazing.
Ladies, tonight is our night, and we look good.
I cannot find a reservation.
I just want to sit down with my friends without three little people clawing all over me.
I'm getting a little angry, and it's doing something ugly to your face.
Joey, you're supposed to be watching our baby. Who has him?
Bones.
He's at the tattoo parlor?
Who would bring a baby to a tattoo parlor? That's dumb.
I know.
That is real dumb.
Okay, so here's the plan. We take them inside, get their hands stamped, and they can't get out. Like Shawshank Redemption.
Bones, my baby.
I called Caprice, and Caprice said she'd take him.
Where's the van?
Oh, I had tonight playing out differently in my mind.
We got a baby to find.
Hank, where's the baby?
I don't know.
Allie, it's me. Just wanted to let you know that everything's going great here. We're all good. We're going to take a little trip to the hospital.
Life is about finding the meaning and the joy and the purpose in all the chaos.
Hon, your job.
It's hard, I know.
Important. That's what I was going to say.
This has been the worst night ever. I honestly don't know how it could get any worse.
Stand down!
How dare you? My husband is pastor.
Sir, they just came in here and started... That was an accident.